Good morning. So today we will talk about arrays. Arrays are a storage which is used in C programming. Normally when we declare a variable, let's say I, as can be seen here, I is actually a box, a place in the memory where we can store numbers because we've declared it as an integer. And if I say I is equal to 7, basically in this box, 7 is entered. Yeah, that's a single box. But suppose I want a contiguous block of memory to be allotted. We call it array. So in the array, we can declare, as can be seen here, a series of numbers, one after the other. The array has a particular length. In this case, we could say the length is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 8 integers are getting stored here. So how do you declare arrays? How do we initialize it? How do we display it? How do we change a value? In the sense, suppose this is 2 and I want to make it 22. What command is required to change the value of an array? And then from scratch, in case this array was empty, how do I populate this array with, let's say, numbers 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8? What is the way to do that? So we will see that in a set of program next one. And we go to dev C++, we open a new file, new source file, we save as, and in our lab folder, the folder should be lab folder, we will store, we'll call this file array, array.c. So we will, extension has to be .c, and we save it, and this is our array program. I'm closing this other windows which are there from here, close. Untitled, yes. So we have array.c, and as we did for the other program, we will have hash include stdio.h. We will have void main. And we will have an array. Now, int is the way we declare it, arr. Square bracket, and we could give a size like this, 10. That's one way of doing it. Be careful of the sensitive of the case. We should make it void. Now, if you look at this, the font size is a bit too large. How do I go about changing the font size? You go to Tools, Editor option, and here in the display, I have set the font as 25. I could make it a more realistic font for the screen size. Let's say 14, and I say okay, and the font size has reduced. Maybe we'll see whether this font works for us. So this is how we declare an array. If we want to initialize with set of values, we don't need to say give the length. We could simply say is equal to, and we could give a series of values here. And the values could be 2, comma. We separate with comma. 5, 3, 7, 6, 1, 9. Which number is not there? 4. Let's say 0. So we have around 9 numbers here. We close the curly brace. And this is how we declare an array. Now, how can I see the content of this array? I will use a loop for I is equal to 0, I less than. How many numbers are there? We have a total of 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So we will say where I is less than 9, because we are starting at 0, I plus plus. And we will display the contents of the array. Now, the reason I am not showing you existing code is I wanted to show you how we develop code from scratch. People have a tendency to copy the code from the internet, see it from a book. Sometimes coding from scratch helps you really understand how programming works. So I need to display the contents of it. So instead of saying arr a number, I'm giving the variable I, and I'll put this inside a printf statement. What are the data contents? Are integer. So we have to say percentage d, which is the format of the integer, and we close the bracket. And that's it. We can put a space here. So the output will come in a nice format. Let's execute this and see what happens. We didn't put get care. Let's do the get care here to make sure the screen doesn't run away. And it's giving an error. I undeclared first use in this function. So what do we have to do? Yes, we have to declare the variable I like we declared earlier programs. Int I, that's it. Compile and run. And we have got the output, which is 25376 1940. Yeah. So that is how we display an array. Now, what is the next step? So after displaying, I would like to change the value, let's say. So what I will do is I will change 6 and I'll make it 66. So ARR, now which position is 6? 2, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Fifth position, but how do we start counting in an array? We have to start with 0. So 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. So ARR 4 is what we need to change and make it equal to, let's say, 66. Yeah, and let's run this. And we notice that the output is not changed. The 6 is as it is. Well, the reason for that is a bit obvious. The thing is, we displayed it before we changed it. Now we need to display it again. So Control C. And after the number is changed, I need to display again. Then only the output will come. Changed output should come. So now the output should be displayed twice. And what we will also do is, we'll put a new line between these two displays. Otherwise, it will come in one single line and confuse us. So we'll put a slash n in between. If you notice, every line we put a semicolon to separate that line from the next line. Save, execute, compile and run. And the output this time, if you notice, 6 has become 66 in the array in the second time it got displayed. Okay. So that is how we implement a basic array. This is how we declare it and initialize it together. This is how we display the content of the array using a for loop and ARRI. This is how we change a particular value in array. So in the next lesson, we will learn how to implement search for this array. Thank you.